Leaders this week. On Friday, they're expected to talk about how the financial crisis has hit some of the world's poorest countries, specifically in Africa. Now, Canada, under the Harper government, has been criticized for moving away from African aid. Dennis Howlett is among those trying to keep the G8's focus on helping the world's poorest people. He is Canadian coordinator for Make Poverty History, and he joins me now from L'Aquila, Italy. Dennis, aid to Africa, where is it sitting right now? On which burner at these discussions?
Well, it's a bit of a disaster. They just, the G8 leaders just released their communique on development in Africa just an hour ago. And it's a disaster, in my point of view, mirroring the disaster behind me here in the earthquake zone in L'Aquila. All they've really done is reaffirmed their previous commitments they made in 2005. And they're not recognizing that the world has changed since then. There is a major economic crisis that is now affecting the poorest countries. Climate change is having a huge impact, especially in the poorest countries as well. And there's a food crisis, and the response just isn't adequate to the need, the growing need.
What specifically, Dennis, is Canada's reaction?
Well, Canada has done its part in doubling aid to Africa, the commitment they made in 2005. But just as they reach that, it looks like now they're going to turn their backs on Africa. And they've announced elimination of seven countries from their priority list that have been in Africa, including countries like Malawi, where Canadian aid was being very effective, was doing a good job, and they're dropped from the list. So Canada is not showing the leadership we hope in terms of stepping up their efforts to help people in Africa.
Now, just to be fair though, is Canada moving some of that money away from Africa to Latin America, where we know there is also an issue of poverty? Can you justify that move?
Well, the countries that they've added to the list, many of them are really added because the government feels we have an economic interest there. So they're hoping, by putting aid, that that's going to help Canadian companies develop trade there.
Is that a bad
thing? But it's not
thing?
Really going to the poorest. Yes. No, I think aid should, the priority should be given to the poorest. That's who needs it the most. And there are lots of countries in Africa where aid can be delivered effectively. There is a good track record, and we should be doing more to build on the success we've had.
You know what I'm having a difficult time understanding, and I'm sure you can help me with this, is we seem to be quibbling over Latin America versus Africa. If you say to somebody, you know, if you're helping a child somewhere in the world who needs help, does it matter whether it's in Latin America or Africa? Why should Africa be a better place rather than Latin America to help a poor child?
Well, first of all, we have to realize that aid plays a relatively small role in helping poor people. Trade, the resources countries are able to mobilize themselves to put into health and education. The remittances of people from those countries living in Canada and other developed countries that they send home, all these things add up way more to aid. The big difference is that Latin America has more of its own resources that they can use for development. They have more in terms of income from trade that they can apply to development. Africa doesn't have that. Africa is where aid can fill that critical gap. And that's why it should continue to be a priority for Canada. It doesn't mean we should abandon Haiti or some of the, but we've got programs there. They were on the priority list before. And those countries can stay on, but we shouldn't be dropping countries like Malawi and Tanzania and others that, you know, where there has been a good track record and where aid is needed the most.
Dennis Howlett, I want to thank you for taking the time to talk to me today.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Okay.